my guru. He was spiritual master, and I met one of the guru. He's a guru of Dr. Svoboda, Robert Svoboda. His guru Vimalananda, and because of Dr. Robert Svoboda, I come to know Vimalananda ji. And Vimalananda was highly enlightened Siddha yogi, and he also taught one of the secrets of pulse, and I learned from that. So I had these two great enlightened masters in my life, my guru Hambir Baba and Dr. Robert Svoboda's guru, Mr. Vimalananda ji, we call him. And these two highly realized enlightened being, they really brought radical change, radical mutation, radical transformation in my life.
And speaking of Vimalananda, he's been such a mystery. You're one of those lucky people outside Robert Svoboda who has met Vimalananda. And you know, I wanted to ask this question in the middle of this interview, but have you seen him perform miracles? Or,
Oh yeah.
Could you please, I mean, please, because I'll tell you what, I've been reading Vimalananda every night. Hmm. You know, the left part, all the part 1, part 2, part 3, Kundalini and all that. And he's such a man of contradictions, but at the same time, he's so brash and human. At the end of the day, you love him. You absolutely love him. You know, he's such a man. But there has been a myth on the internet that such a man never existed. That is one viewpoint, you know. So I somehow do know his real name also. I do not know if it should be said, you know, I tried to find out, you know, about him, but
his real name is, he called himself as Bimla ka Bacha. His mother's name was Bimla, therefore he called Bimla ka Bacha, but out of love he called. If you ask me about Vimalananda ji, with kind permission of Vimalananda ji and Dr. Robert Svoboda, I will share with you my personal experience with Vimalananda ji. My wife, Usha, and me, we were living in the hospital quarters. I was a chief medical officer, and Vimalananda used to come to Pune every Saturday, Sunday, and Robert used to tell me that Pappu, we call Pappu also, Pappu has come, he has called you, and I used to go and sit under his lotus feet. Just whatever he talks, I listen. So, on that day, it was Saturday, I went to see him. He will always inquire, how is Ma? Every woman he will call Ma. How is Ma? Ma means my wife. Oh, she is okay. How is Pranav? Oh, he's fine. How is Pranav? He will ask, he will inquire about everyone. He said, no. Ma is not okay. She had a headache. Oh. And you never told me. And really she had a headache and I never told him. And then you gave this medicine and nothing worked.
Oh, he even told which medicine you gave?
Yeah. How he knows that about which medicine I have given? So he told me you gave her Sutsegar, Kamaduda, Moti, Basma. Nothing worked. And you are doing things last 1 week. Isn't it so? I say yes. And she get headache here in the right side. So he say, okay, now go back to your quarters. And there are all yellow flowers. And among yellow flower, there is only one red flower. Just pick up that flower and bring it to me. Amazing, I came there. There were all yellow flowers. And among yellow flower, there was only one red flower. My God. When I saw, oh my God, how he knows that there's only one red flower and it is just near your window. So I plug up that flower and I had a scooter. I kicked the scooter, kept the flower well safe in my pocket, and I went there to see him. So when he saw, then he looked at the flower. He was smiling, he was talking to the flower. He spoke some language. And then he gave that flower to me. He said, put this flower in your pocket, go home and encircle this flower counterclockwise 5 times, and then put that flower in your pocket, don't look back, go straightway to the Sangam bridge and drop that flower into the water.
Oh my.
And I did that. I just followed his order. And since then she had never headache.
Oh my God.
Isn't it a miracle?
Miraculous.
So this is a miracle that Vimalananda ji did. So I cannot forget him. I love him. And he had such a great love, compassion. Though he looks controversial, but amazing. He is full of love, compassion, clarity, and he was highly enlightened, Siddha. He followed the left hand of God, which is not for everyone. So this is regarding that. So these two people, they helped me in my life. That may be the result, I am at peace and bliss.
One more question. You know, he talks about his three mentors. Did you ever get the chance to meet any of his mentors?
I heard from him. He used to call one Bada Baba, Mangal Das Ji. But one mentor, he called Baba Ji. And he sent me to some ashram and to see that mentor and take his darshan and give him some medicine. I did that. That was according to his instruction. And that's it. But I have not seen the other two. But he talked about his three great mentors. But we have not seen him. But whatever he sent me, he may be one of his friends, who knows. Because these Siddhas, they don't disclose everything to the people. They keep it secret. There may be some divine reason. And maybe I saw someone, he may not be his mentor, who knows.
Was he also into Ayurveda and all that?
Oh, he himself was a pranacharya. He has such a knowledge, he knows everything about kusti, you know, kusti, wrestling. He gave some Hanuman chaddi to Chaburan Boke and he was in the Kesari, something. Means he had a lot of miraculous things. Plus, he talked about cricket, mathematics, geography, Jyotish, Ayurveda. He was master of all, and he knows everything, even cricket, even modern medicine, modern pharmacology, even ophthalmology. My God, one person has such an intense knowledge of every subject I have seen with my eyes. Thanks to Dr. Robert Sagoda, because of him, I got a chance to see such a great enlightened person.
I vaguely remember in that book, Robert was studying in Pune with you.
Robert was studying in Pune and I was one of his teachers teaching Chikitsa Ayurveda. And he was a very bright, brilliant student at that time.